is Alexander Cameron, and I'd like to show you how I break down Chapter 7 in my textbook. This video was created in 2019, and I'm from Peterson Middle School. So, let's get into it.
In Section 1 of this chapter, we will cover the election of 1800, Mayberry versus Madison, and judicial review. We will cover the election of 1800 first. In the year 1800, former President John Adams wanted to get reelected, and he was running against Thomas Jefferson, Aaron Burr, and Charles Pinckney. Adams and Pinckney lost, but there was a tie between Jefferson and Burr. Finally, Jefferson won against Burr, and Thomas Jefferson became president. Next in Chapter 7, we will cover Mayberry versus Madison, a famous early judicial case. This case helped establish the Supreme Court's power to check the power of other branches of government. It is important because it established the court as the final authority of the Constitution. Quickly, I'd like to cover judicial review. Judicial review is the power to declare an act of Congress unconstitutional. Okay, that's it for Section 1. On to Section 2. Section 2 is made up of two parts, the Louisiana Purchase and the exploration of western lands. In the year 1800, America was not the country we know today. American territory expanded west of the Mississippi River, but no further. When Americans tried to buy New Orleans from France, Napoleon offered to sell all of Louisiana to them. The price? $15 million, a huge bargain. Jefferson jumped on the deal, and Louisiana was now part of America. Next, we will look at the exploration of western lands. The first major exploration was the Lewis and Clark Expedition. Sent to find the Northwest Passage, the trip took 2 years and was very helpful in improving relations with the natives. However, the explorers did not find the Northwest Passage. The next major expedition was Pike's Expedition. Ordered to find the starting point of the Red River, he walked into the Spanish territory and was caught. When released, he gave Americans their first description of the Southwest. That's it for Section 2. Moving on to Section 3. Section 3 is made up of three parts: violations of neutrality, conflict in the West, and call for war. First, we will cover violations of neutrality. So what were these violations of neutrality? Basically, British ships began stopping American ships and searching for former British soldiers to join into their army. In order to respond to Britain, Jefferson wanted an embargo, or banning of trade, with the whole world. The law devastated U.S. merchants and Jefferson's popularity. It didn't even affect Britain. Next, we will cover conflict in the West. Conflicts over territories between America and Native Americans continued. One leader named Tecumseh pushed settlers off their lands, but was defeated in the Battle of Tippecanoe. Finally, we will be covering call for war. People named War Hawks in Congress really wanted a war against Britain, but were faced with plenty of opposition. Some argued that America was not powerful enough yet. However, when James Madison was elected, he saw a need for a war and asked Congress to vote. Congress voted for a war, and war was declared. That's it for Section 3. Now on to Section 4. Section 4 is made up of two sections, the War of 1812 and the effects of the war. First, we will cover the events of the war. War at sea was successful for the Americans, embarrassing Britain's larger fleet. Battles along the Canadian border at first failed, with battles such as the attack on Fort Detroit. Later battles, like the Battle of Lake Erie, were won by the U.S. Meanwhile, down south, Native Americans took up arms and attacked. However, after a few successful battles, they lost to Andrew Jackson and signed a treaty. Back east, Britain attacked overland, destroying Washington, D.C. After the attack on Washington, British moved south to New Orleans. However, in the Battle of New Orleans, Andrew Jackson's army destroyed the British. Finally, we'll cover the effects of the war. The Treaty of Ghent officially ended the War of 1812, and Andrew Jackson was made a war hero. Also, the lack of goods boosted American manufacturing.
Well, thanks for watching, and as always, keep thinking deeper. Bye!